Why don't you call me back in about 20 minutes? I'm gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
My name is Sarah Choo Jing, and I'm a multidisciplinary fine artist. I'm currently based in London.
Go ahead, make my day. Whoa, what happened? Are you alright?
I think I've always been interested in the relationship between space and time, because it kind of gives us this sense of alienation and isolation, social alienation and isolation, which I feel very strongly for. And so with every piece of my work, I think it reveals that interest that I have in that sense of loneliness in contemporary society, because I find it really ironic how in such a fast-paced society today, and you know, we are all, I mean, in a populated city, there are so many of us, but yet we are still very much alone. I think cities in general really intrigue me. I think because I really enjoy observing people. So I think a lot of times, especially at night, I enjoy taking night walks, because sometimes I just like to stop at a specific place. It's kind of like people watching, but I like to follow like specific people or you know, watch people behaving in groups. So I think in a city there, I mean, because it's so congested, you have so many different kinds of people. And in each city, everybody is kind of different as well. The architecture is also different in different cities. So I think I see each city like a set, almost like a stage. You know, you see different people coming in, doing different things, and in a way performing, consciously or unconsciously, performing in front of a camera. And I think, I don't know, I see myself as a camera sometimes.
Okay, so I see myself as a multidisciplinary fine artist, and this simply means that I do works that are more defined, not defined by their medium, more defined by the theme, the consistent theme that runs throughout the work. So all my works, they have this similar theme of social alienation and isolation within contemporary society. And I feel and I believe that they all actually to a certain extent depict very identifiable characters in society. And be it in paintings or in my video works, I'm always constantly trying to reflect on that kind of mundane life, reflect on people reflecting on their mundane life, and also the potential narrative in all the artwork. So with, for example, the hidden dimension, you see that it seems like I'm trying to tell a sort of story here. You see the different characters of my family coming together to do something. However, in my other work, I would say maybe Waiting for the Elevator is another panoramic work. It's similar. Again, you see that those characters there. And again, there's that suggestion of a narrative, but you're not really given the story. So I think that's what's similar in all my works. I don't really want to kind of zoom in on any particular medium, because I always believe in choosing the most appropriate medium to convey my intention. So if, for example, the work works best as a painting, I will present it as a painting. If it works best as an installation or an experience, right, in a room, then I would execute the work in that manner. Because I always think it's about the viewer experiencing the work personally, and I would like that to be maximized. Yeah. So I wouldn't zoom in on one particular. And also in terms of the medium, like what does the medium do to the work? You know, when you are viewing a painting, it's just on a wall and it's flat, right? So the way you view it is more like you're viewing it as an object, like you're admiring it as an object, versus, for example, with one of my upcoming shows in London for the solo exhibition, that would be more immersive because it's more about the experience. It's about walking into a space feeling like you're walking back in time or into a different situation. So then that you can't, or at least I don't believe you can just put works on a wall. You have to kind of curate the space and the environment, the setting, the smell,